Hello students, welcome to Devanagari YouTube channel. Today I will teach wind. This is from class 9 CBSE English NCERT, written by Subramania Bharati. In this video you will get explanation with important question and answer in the end. So let's start with explanation. Introduction to the poem. As the name suggests, this poem is about wind. However, the wind is a natural phenomenon. And in the poem, the poet describes the power of the wind and calls wind destructive. Further, he links the destructive power of the wind with the difficulties of life. He says that weak people break down easily, but stronger people emerge out stronger. Also, the poem gives a very important lesson that we should be mentally tough and physically strong in order to survive the hardships of life. However, a weak person crumbles and breaks down like an old building. So it is necessary that we should make these destructive forces our friends with our determination and strength. So let's move on to the poem. The stanza 1 says, "Wind comes softly, don't break the shutters of the windows. Don't scatter the papers, don't throw down the books in the shelf. There, look what you did. You threw them all down. You tore the pages of the books. You brought rain again. You are very clever at poking fun at weaklings." So meaning of this poem is that, first of all, let's see some word meanings. The poking fun means making fun of something, and weaklings mean a person with a weak, who is weak. So this stanza says that the poet is talking to the winds. He asks the wind to come softly. So he is saying that the wind should not be very strong, loud. It should be soft and subtle. Then he says that the wind is very powerful. It is destructive. It breaks the shutters of windows and scatters the papers. When the wind is very powerful, all the books which are kept on the shelf fall down. So here the poet is describing the power of the wind. Then he says to the wind to look at the destruction that it had done. Whenever there is a strong wind, all the things that are weak, like small plants, tiny children, etc., they all get scattered, and they can even fall and get hurt. We can say that in the initial part of the poem, the poet is referring to wind as a young child. He is saying that it should come softly, just like a small child does. In the later part, we come to know that the wind is destructive, just like a youth, just like a young boy or a young girl who is full of energy, violence and destruction. So this is the meaning of stanza 1. Stanza 2, frail crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling woods, crumbling bodies, crumbling lives, crumbling hearts. So meaning of this poem, meaning of this stanza, the word meanings of crumbling is falling or to cause something to break. Meaning of rafter is sloping beam which support the roof of the building. So this stanza says that here the word crumbling is repeated so many times to lay stress that everything crumbles in the face of a strong wind. So the writer is saying that when wind is very powerful, it is very strong, it leads to breakage of everything. Houses which are weak fall. Doors which are weak fall. The beams on which the roof of the buildings are supported, they also fall. All the wooden structures fall. All bodies of people fall. Animals, lives, hurts. So he is saying that everything crumbles. Everything that is weak react by falling down and breaking in the face of adversity. So the poet is saying that whenever a weak person faces any adversity or challenge in life, he breaks down and falls. So this is the meaning of stanza 2. Now let's move on to stanza 3. "He won't do what you tell him. So come, let's build strong homes. Let's join the doors firmly. Practice to firm the body. Make the heart steadfast. Do this and the wind will befriend with her, friends with us. So meaning of this stanza is that. So meaning of steadfast is firm. So this stanza says that the poet wants us to make friends with the wind. That is, the adversities in our life, the adversities in our life. He says that the problems will not listen to us. They will come. So we should be prepared. In preparation, we should build strong homes and close the doors of our house firmly so that the wind cannot get into. And then he says that we should also make our bodies strong and hearts firm to face these challenges. And then once we are strong enough, all the challenges will be like friends. We will not feel that they are troublesome. This is the meaning of stanza 3. Let's move on to stanza 4. The wind blows out weak fires. He makes strong fires roar and flourish. His friendship is good. We praise him every day. Meaning of flourish is grow. In this stanza, the poet has kept the wind on a pedestal. He is comparing the wind to God. He says that wind is God and we praise wind every day. He adds that everything that is weak gets finished off in the face of the strong wind. And all the things that are strong flourish and grow to become stronger. He is giving us a very important message that we should not feel bad that we are facing so many challenges and adversities in life. We should make ourselves physically and mentally strong to face these challenges. And once we are strong enough, we will overcome the challenges, we will become friends with them, and then we will be happy that we had these challenges in our life because they help us become stronger and better. So this was all the poem about this. I have explained all the chapters. Let's summarize all the poem in a nutshell, what this poem tells about. So in the poem, the poet is talking to the wind and he asks the winds to come softly. Poet also says that the wind should not be strong, as it should come delicately and softly. Then he describes that powerful wind is destructive and it breaks the shutters and windows and scatters the paper. Moreover, when the wind is very powerful, then it takes down the books from the shelves. After that, he asks the wind to look at the damage it has caused. Further, whenever the wind is strong, all the weak things like plants, children, etc. get fearful and sometimes get hurt. In the initial part of the poem, the poet is referring to the wind as a young child. Firstly, he said that it comes softly as a child does. Later on, we come to know that it became destructive like a youth, full of energy, violence and destructive. Then again we can understand the another stanza that in a nutshell, that in the next pair he continuously repeated the word crumbling to lay stress that everything crumbles in the face of strong wind. So the poet wants to say that everything breaks when the wind is very strong and powerful. He says that weak houses, weak doors, beams, wooden structures, bodies of people, animals, etc. all fall and crumbles. In addition, everything which is weak react by breaking or falling down in the face of hardship. Hence, the poet says that whenever weak people faces and hardship or challenge in life, they fall or break down. Then, in the next paragraph, he addresses the wind as a wind god. And he says that the powerful god of wind examines, meaning it shifts people and lose who are, and those who are weak fall down and get crushed. Therefore, here the poet made a comparison between wheat and people. Wheat is wheat, wheat and people. Just like we sort the wheat to separate the grain from the chaff, In the same way, the wind god separates the strong people from weak people. Moreover, when there is a strong wind, all things that are weak fall and get crushed. After that, the poet wants us to make friends with the wind, that is hardship in our lives. He says that we should be ready for the problems as they will come and will not listen to us. Also, we should build strong homes and close the doors of our house firmly so that wind cannot enter them. Moreover, the poet says that we should make our hearts and bodies stronger to face these challenges. And when we are strong enough to face challenges, then we will not feel troublesome. Then last stanza says that he keeps the wind on a pedestal and comparing it to God. The poet says that wind is a god and we praise it daily. He also adds that everything that is weak gets over in the face of strong wind. In addition, all the things that are strong flourish and grow stronger. The poet gives us the message, we should make ourselves physically and mentally strong to face these challenges. Also, when we become their friends, then we will be happy, as they will help us to become stronger and better because the challenges and hardship of life makes us better. So let's move on to question and answer. So first question is, what are the things the wind does in the first stanza? Answer is, in the first stanza, the wind shutters breaks the shutters. Note this point. In this first stanza, the wind shutters breaks the shutters. Shutters breaks will be together. S-H-U-T-T-E-R-S-B-R-E-A-K-S. Shutters breaks the shutters of windows, scatters the papers, throws down the books from the shelf, tears the pages of the books, and brings showers of rain. Second question is, have you seen anybody winnow grain at home or in a paddy field? What is the word in your language for winnowing? What do people use for winnowing? Give the words in your language if you know them. So we will say that yes, I have seen many women winnowing grain in villages. Pachoranize, that spelling is P-A-C-H-O-R-A-N-A-I-S. Pachorana is the word in my language for winnowing. People use chajor, C-H-A-A-J-O-R, winnowing fan for winnowing purpose. So question number 3 says that, what does the poet say the wind god winnows? The poet answer is, the poet says that the wind god winnows the weak crumbling houses, doors, rafters, wood, bodies, lives and hearts, and then crushes them all. Question number 4 is, what should we do to make friends with the wind? Answer is, to make friends with the wind, we need to build strong homes with firm doors. We should also make ourselves physically and mentally strong by building strong, firm bodies and having steadfast hearts. Question number 5 is, what do the last 4 lines of the poem mean to you? So we will say, in the last 4 lines, the poet inspires us to face the wind, which symbolizes the hardships of our life, courageous. He tells us the wind can only extinguish the weak fires, it intensifies the strong ones. Similarly, adversities defer the weak hearted but make stronger those who have unfaltering will. In such a case, befriending the wind or the hardship of life makes it easier for us to face them. Question number 6 says, how does the poet speak to the wind, in anger or with humor? You must also have seen or heard of the wind crumbling lives. What is your response to this? Is it like the poet's? So we will answer, the poet speaks to the wind with anger. Yes, strong winds are known to cause plenty of damage and destruction to both life and property. Storms, cyclones, gales, and strong winds cause havoc on land. They uproot trees, bring down houses, tear down electric posts, and claim lives. They also cause damage to boats and frighten the poor sailors and fishermen out at sea. Yet I do not agree with the poet that the wind only crumbles lives. The wind is responsible for bringing rain. It cools the land and makes the climate pleasant. Today, wind energy is harnessed for several useful purposes, including turning windmills, wind turbines, and generating electricity. So all the chapters questions are explained nicely. Write down these notes and do pause the video and understand this chapter clearly. If you have any doubt, do ask in the comment section. I will surely reply. Give a big fat thumbs up for this video. Do subscribe to this channel and turn on all notification and press that bell icon. See you soon in the next chapter. Bye bye.